Here we have a Sony Watchman. This seems to be a rather fancy model because it not only has FM stereo through the headphone output, but it also has a video input, which is actually quite useful because, of course, these days analog TV is pretty much not on the air anymore. There are some low-powered analog TV stations, but I can't pick up any in my area. So all I would get on the TV these days is just static, but I can use this hopefully as a video monitor. I'll try that out, see how good the quality is. YouTube user UXW Bill has a similar but slightly larger Sony Watchman. His is the model FD-30A. And if you want a good explanation of how the picture tube and these work, I suggest you watch his video because he has the original owner's manual, which has a diagram of how the CRT is constructed. Now, I looked on Sony's website, and although this model is in their online database, they do not have the owner's manual available for it. On this side, you have switches for VHF or UHF TV, and the radio has AM, FM local, and FM distant. On this side, you have the volume and tuning knobs, and your function switch for off radio or TV. There's the video input I mentioned. There's the stereo headphone jack. Of course, it's only stereo and FM. There was stereo TV in 1985 when this was made, but it was brand new, so it was not widely used yet. And it also has a 6-volt DC input. Also runs on 4 AA batteries in this little door here. And you get a stand to prop it up. It says manufactured April 1985 in Japan. It's the model number FD-30A. It says flat black and white TV FM stereo AM receiver. If we pull out this stand, there is just the right angle for viewing. So now we'll turn on the TV. Of course, all you get is static, and since I have my FM transmitter on 87.9 and the audio for channel 6 is 87.75, if we tune this to channel 6, you'll get the audio from my transmitter. Switch over to the radio. The screen goes blank. This is AM right now.
It's a new program that rewards carpoolers, road trippers.
He's such a dick. And that is, I till right about now.
Sounds a little bit distorted, but of course you can't expect great audio from such a small speaker. It's probably 1.5 inches, I would say, judging by the opening there. So, of course, most of this space where you would think they would be able to fit a larger speaker is actually taken up by the CRT in this space here, which is facing up to reflect off of the screen. Let's try FM.
Accident being cleared. 35 northbound at County Road in Aberdeen, right lane closed because of a gas main break.
You get a little volume graph, which is just an orange indicator showing through the little window there.
Smaller, the number that is, because of debris on the outbound helix.
Seems like the audio amplifier on this thing is rather weak, because once you turn it up past a certain level, it doesn't get louder, it just gets more distorted. And this is with good batteries, so it's not a case of weak batteries causing the distortion.
There's the FM stereo indicator, which shows up even though we're not listening to it in stereo, because it's just a built-in speaker.
Antenna does pull out and swivel. It's not too long though, so probably TV reception would not be too great with this little thing, but good enough for local stations. Well, it turns out when this thing says video input, it means it's video only, because I tried one of these stereo cables here to try to get both video and audio into this thing, and it did not work. It would show the video, but all I got out of the sound was just static. So it appears that this is only a video input. In UXW Bill's model, it says AV input, which definitely means that model has both audio and video, but this one just says video input, so I'll take it at its word that it's only video. So I'm using a mono jack here to feed in the signal from this Atari Flashback console. And I must say, the quality of the label on this is definitely rather cheap, because it's all falling apart here. Now, when I first plugged in the video input, the picture was rolling, and I knew there's got to be a vertical hold on this somewhere. It turns out it's on the bottom here. Get vertical hold and contrast, although the contrast doesn't seem to do a whole lot to affect the image. Not the clearest thing in the world, because it's a CRT, it's not an LCD, so you don't get pixel perfect sharpness out of this. But for something like a video game, it is okay. It's about the best I can do to show you how this thing looks, because I've got the camera on manual white balance, manual exposure, and manual focus. And you have to remember, the CRT on this thing is about 2 inches, so if you're watching this on something like a 30-inch big screen monitor, you're obviously watching a greatly magnified version of what the real thing is, so you have to keep in mind how small this monitor is. But I'll find something to play on this Atari here. Let's try Centipede. So it is watchable. No sound, obviously, which is unfortunate. But I wouldn't want to use this as a computer monitor, because I think even 40 column text will be pushing it in terms of readability. But for video games, it's okay. And in case you're unfamiliar with it, this Atari Flashback console is actually based on a Nintendo. It's based on a NES on a chip, so it's actually emulating Atari games on a Nintendo platform, which is one of the reasons why it was not really faithful to the originals. Although this is a pretty good version of Centipede, but some of the other games on this thing are definitely, they definitely suffer quite a bit from the Nintendo emulation. So, I think you get the idea. That's the video input of the Sony Watchman.